Hi, the question, determine the reflection coefficients. Number one, if load is equal to Z0, characteristic impedance. Number two, ZL is load is short circuited. Number three, load is open circuited. And also find out magnitude of reflection coefficient if ZL is purely reactive. So this is a very important question, November 2016, set 4. For 8 marks, this question is given. Very simple question. First, let us find out what is the first given. The first given condition is the load is equal to Z0. So this condition is also called as matched load condition. If in the same question, if it is given, ZL is matched load, then you have to take ZL as Z0. So what is the first case? So this is the characteristic impedance of the line. So what is the characteristic impedance of the line? So this is the characteristic impedance of the line. So what is the load? It is a matched load. So that is the load is also the characteristic impedance. This is called as matched load. This is called as matched load. So what you have to use the simple formula, the reflection coefficient at load. Remember that this is the reflection coefficient at load. Very simple formula, ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0. ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0. Since it is given, load is characteristic impedance, Z0 minus Z0 by Z0 plus Z0. So therefore, the reflection coefficient will come out as 0. So this is the formula we have to employ, simple formula, reflection coefficient formula. The load reflections coefficient formula. Next, number two. So what is the given? The load is short circuited. Number two, that means the load is short circuited, the second case. So that is, if you take, this is the transmission line with the characteristic impedance Z0, the load is short circuited. The load is short circuited means ZR is equal to 0. That is, load is short circuited. In fact, ZL is given. So therefore, what is the reflection coefficient at load? Simple formula, ZR minus Z0 by ZR plus Z0. If you substitute ZL, in fact, ZL minus Z0 by, so what is this? 0 minus Z0 by 0 plus Z0. So it will come out as minus 1. That means, in this case also, if the wave is instant like this, on the load, the wave is completely reflected back with 180 degrees phase difference. With 180 degrees phase difference, the wave is completely reflected back. The reflections are maximum. What you can write in this question? The reflections are maximum when load is short. The entire wave is completely reflected back into the source. The third case is load is open circuited. So that is what we have to write. Open means ZL is equal to infinity. We have to substitute, the load is short, we have to substitute ZL is equal to 0. Now, so write the simple case. So this is the characteristic impedance Z0 of the line. So what is the load? The load is open. So that is, what is its meaning? The load is infinity. Now in this case, so what is the reflection coefficient at load? ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0. Since load is infinity, so divided numerator and denominator by ZL. So 1 minus Z0 by ZL by 1 plus Z0 by ZL. If you substitute load is equal to infinity, this term will come out 0 and this term will come out 0. It will come out, the reflection coefficient at load is 1. You can clearly check that in this case also the reflections are maximum in this case. The load is short circuited or load is open circuited, the wave is completely reflected back, that means reflections are maximum. When the load is matched load, the entire input power is transferred to the load. Last case, let us check out the last case. The load is purely reactive load. So that is
load is taken as plus or minus Jx, whether it may be positive reactants or negative reactants. So therefore, the reflection coefficient at load is given by form a simple form of ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0, ZL plus Z0. So what it is asked? It is asked J plus or minus Jx minus Z0 by plus or minus J plus or minus Jx plus Z0. What it is asked? It is asked only the magnitude of reflection coefficient. What is the complex number square root of Z0 square plus X square by square root of Z0 square plus X square? It will come out as 1. So in this case also, what you have to write? The reflections are maximum. The reflections are maximum when the load is also purely reactive load. So this is the answer you have to write to get full marks for this question. Thank you.